What the fuck?
It's Barbie and it's Kim Petras.
Hey there, everybody, and welcome back to The Trick Room. As usual, I'm your host, Operations Paul, and today we're reacting to a song I've been anticipating for a really long time. That is Kim Petras featuring Nicki Minaj, Alone. I don't know about you, but it feels like Kim has been teasing this song for months at this point, with the sample of Better Off Alone by Alice DJ being all over my TikTok.
It's Barbie and it's Kim Petras.
But also the hook where she's like, it's Barbie and it's Kim Petras. The girls were gagged the day that was released, we have to say it. I have been digging a lot of Kim's music recently. The leaked album Problematique was so good on Holy Was Filler, I don't really care for that song. But Burr, which I did react to over on this channel, I really enjoyed. So I hope this is going to continue the upward trajectory of these releases for me. And I really have stanned Kim all the way back from the singles era through to Clarity, Turn Off the Lights Volume 1 and 2. She has a lot of really good music. But part of me is worried about this song as well. Like, Better Off Alone is so good, but even the unreleased song Xanax by Lindsay Lohan, I mean, it samples it and it's like one of the best songs ever. I can't believe we never got an official release of that. Lindsay, you're going to jail again. And the last said about Kim working with Dr. Luke again, despite being told she was not going to do that anymore, is probably for the better in this case. The song is actually leaked a few days ago online. I've been avoiding it, but the reaction has definitely been mixed. There are people who have loved it, people who really like it, and then people who are like, it is such a flop, and I'm ready to see where I am on that list. So sit back, relax, and get ready for our reaction to Alone by Kim Petras and Nicki Minaj. Now B is what we've been teased.
It's Barbie.
I love that hook.
I've been trying to give it to you all night. What's it gonna take to get you all alone?
I love this production. What a bop. Come on.
Yeah, don't you wait, don't think about it. Yeah, don't you wait, just come on over now.
She's horny again. This is the horny anthem of the summer. Okay. Oh, she's hungry for it. Not sure about the beat change there, but she's got stamina. But it still is good, but it's fine muted in the background. You better be big. It's slow. I want to shake. Come on. But she's teased this part for so long. I wanted like a spice. That part I love that part. Oh, Nicki!
Just be back. We throw jabs, they get jagged. We be like Jag, call it Kim Petty.
Oh,
I ride brand new range, I just painted it Betty. I set trends, I'm not the one to do the imitate thing.
Oh,
you know, this cake, he doing a taste.
Her big juicy.
Get ready, they may sting. It is Barbie and it's Kim Petty.
That part. This is a really good feature from Nicki. That was really good verse. The queen of rap. Come on, last chorus. Come on, get. I want more. Amp it up. That part, my favorite part. I want more though. It's over. Like, My feelings on this song already are so mixed. The first thing I want to say is the best part of the song is the bit we've already heard. And I think Kim has done this a few times now with Coconuts, and then also Sam did it on Unholy. Like, they kind of have been teasing the best bit. And then when the song comes out, the other bits, like the verses, kind of just feel more muted. And like, we're basically hearing the explosion in these teases before we see the like build up of it. So it feels less earned when we get there. I don't know if it's just me that feels like that, but like teasing it that much can actually have a detriment because it sets expectations. If I remove those expectations and think about this as a full song that I've heard for the first time, that was so fun. Like, you can tell my reaction, I really enjoyed it. And you can tell by my curls, I enjoyed it as well. Like, they are starting to develop because I wanted to move, like I wanted to dance. And I really love Nicki's verse as well. Like, Nicki for me is the undisputed queen of rap. Like, genuinely, I just really stan her, and her features usually go hard. except for Jesse Nelson. Girl, get off my page. And I just feel like that it's Barbie and it's Kim Petras. Like, I just feel like that part is going to be iconic forever. Lyrically, there's not a lot to unpack, no pun intended, because I just feel like it is a standard Kim sax song. You know, we've got an entire EP called Slut Pop, which is dedicated to this kind of sound, and this would fit in there for me. I mean, one of the lyrics is, I could write it all night, watching write it all night. I mean, it's not going to win a Pulitzer Prize for writing, but it doesn't need to. And in Nicki's verse specifically, I really love the lyrics. All this cake, keep him wanna tasting. I send shots, get ready, they may sting. It rhymes better when she does it. But I just feel like those lyrics specifically speak to the theming of the song. Like, it's just about sex, having fun, having a big juicy booty, but also with that typical Nicki sort of like bite to it. You know, she's sending shots, she's sending stings. But I also will say, looking at the lyrics, it is one of Nicki's more generic. Like, it's not as like double entendre or really like that high level in terms of the wordplay, which I do come to expect from Nicki. I think sitting back and thinking about it, like, if I ever want to just put on a song and dance and have a good time to, I will definitely stick this on. But the verse beat is so remedial in comparison to like the bombastic sample of it in the chorus that it does take me out of it a little bit. You know, I need time. Like, I really need to sit and think about this one. It's definitely like really fun. I really enjoyed it. Does it stack up as well as songs like Burr on the first listen? I don't know. I feel like taking the fact that we heard about it so far in advance out of it, it's difficult to do that. But it was good pop goodness and good fun. Is it better than Xanax, Bill and Zilohan? No. It was never gonna be. And that has been my very first reaction to Alone by Kim Petras and Nicki Minaj. Please sound off in the comments of what you thought about this song. Did you enjoy it? Did it kind of flop for you? And also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed this video. Please let me know what else you want me to react to over on the channel in the comments as well. And as usual, you're now trapped in the trick room until I return, so I know I'm gonna see you very soon. Thank you.